lineups. Lots of interesting matchups tonight. Stick around. We'll be right back with more. Hi, everyone. We're coming to you live on 2K Sports, bringing you the NBA. And on tap tonight, it's the Dallas Mavericks going up against the Charlotte Hornets here at Spectrum Center. This is Kevin Harlan, and joining me tonight, Chris Webber and Greg Anthony, with our Hall of Famer David Aldridge reporting from the sideline. A moment now to check out some numbers for Terry Rozier.
And the stat to look at is his steal total. Over the last five games, he's been focusing more on his defense, trying to be a disruptor, and it's made them a lot tougher on D.
And with pregame routines coming to an end, we're just about ready for our tip-off. First, though, let's get a report from the sideline and say hello to David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. The NBA flattened the draft lottery odds in 2019. Last season, it introduced the play-in tournament. It's too soon to say for sure, but it sure seems like the league has gone a long way in trying to motivate teams to compete for the playoffs and not for picks.
I love it, David. I got to tell you, got to give them a lot of credit. Thank you for that report. Some of the best in the game go at it here tonight, Chris. What an incredible guard matchup we have here in this one.
There are some of the all-time greats playing at the guard spot these days. I mean, this is going to be a fun matchup to watch.
Now, a look at Dallas's starting lineup. Luka Doncic out there with Jalen Brunson. Then there's Reggie Bullock. Then there's Dwight Powell. And it's Finney Smith in at the four. And for the Hornets, the guard spots are filled by Ball and Rozier. Bridges and Washington are up in the forward positions. And it's Plumlee in at the five. Now, here's Doncic. In the game against Boston, very impressive. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
And you know you're special when you're drafted third, and people still can't believe you slipped that far. That's how good Doncic has been in his young career.
This is his first chance at the line tonight.
And 74%, yeah, you know, so-so. He probably wouldn't mind seeing it a little bit higher.
And he makes the first. And Greg, at the time of the 2018 draft, Luka Doncic was regarded as the best international prospect ever.
And that sounds right because, you know, coming from Europe, a lot of people assume that he's got a low ceiling, but he's surpassing all those expectations.
All free throws good from Doncic.
A generational talent. Doncic able to carry a team and make others around him better.
Brunson against Rozier. Yep, that one goes.
Well, this is Rozier at his most dangerous, using his agility to completely outwit the defender.
Now the pass to Powell. Now here's Brunson. There's the drive. Plumlee with the rebound. Pass the ball. Now here's Washington. He's guarded closely. Clock at six. Shoots it. And too long on the shot.
Oh, their movement is good, and they get the ball into the right hand. Now, usually, he drops those in between jumpers.
It's good.
A playmaker of Doncic's talents wasn't missing that gap. He quickly gets the ball to the wide-open man.
And we're about a minute and a half into the first quarter. Rozier against Brunson. And it's Rozier missing. Rozier's gone 1-3 from the field here. Bullock passes to Brunson. Here's Finney-Smith. He's covered by Washington. Here's Doncic. And it's blocked.
Oh, nice defense from Bridges. When he hustles like this, he's capable of swatting shots.
And here's Bullock from the arc. That one's off. He starts the game with a miss. Now, here's Ball. He's guarded by Bullock. And Plumlee kicks to Rozier. And the Hornets miss again.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
Doncic passes to Brunson. Back to Doncic. That one misses. Excellent D there from Ball. Rozier the pass to Bridges. And it's slammed in by Bridges.
Yeah, Rozier has great vision on the floor and sees his teammate in the ideal situation.
Here's Doncic. Incredible numbers looking at his scoring averages. He's currently scoring more than 28 points a game. Pass to Brunson. Powell with a screen on Rozier. Here's Brunson. Plumlee with the steal. Ball against Doncic. Now, here's Ball. He's tightly guarded. On the wing, Rozier. Lays it up off the glass.
Decision pass by Ball. He wasn't going to waste an easy dive to a wide open man.
Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Doncic outside. He dishes it to Powell. Dallas moving it around. On the wing, Doncic. He's guarded by Plumlee. Lets it go from 11. The Hornets pull it in. Last time they came together was in Dallas where they fell to the Mavericks.
Well, if they want to avoid the outcome of that first meeting, they'll need to be stronger on the glass. They were completely outmatched in the last one.
They needed more fire and intensity tonight. Even if they don't win the battle of the boards, they have to put up a fight.
And Dallas calls their first timeout of the game.
And with LaMelo Ball, this team struck gold. Exactly what the Hornets needed. Great production and a face of the franchise type of talent.
Harrell, he's checked in for Charlotte. It's getting late in the season. Let's now see the standings out east. Taking a look at the Hornets, they would be at the golf course if the playoffs happened today, looking to make a final push.
And you know, for the Hornets, they've shown me some very good things this season. But that next step, those qualities that could make them true contenders, just haven't been there.
Yeah, and I'm sure they're disappointed in that. I mean, they were hoping to take that next step.
Now here's Brunson. A 14-point game for him in the win against the Celtics in Boston.
Slammed down by Doncic. A monster in the backcourt at 6'7".
So it's the Hornets now. They want to keep rolling here following the win against the Thunder.
And you gotta love a team that can maintain its composure on the road, take good shots, and knock them down with confidence.
Yeah, not getting overwhelmed is important. Poise is something that you need to have in order to win on the road.
And here is Doncic following LaMelo Ball's three.
Now flying high and throwing it down with the one hand.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys. Hornets leading by three. Ball dishes to Harrell. Passes it to Rozier. And it's the Hornets, another three.
Yeah, there's 6 points on consecutive three balls. They're finding holes now in the deep.
The pass to Bullock. Bridges with the board. Charlotte has gone 2 or 3 from deep so far in this game. Ball feeling it out a bit. Nice D from Doncic. Mavericks trail by 6. Bullock passes to Finney-Smith. Brunson against Rozier. The Hornets pull it in.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Pass to Bridges. That shot is off target. That makes him 2 for 3. Pass to Brunson. Back to Doncic. Powell sets a screen for Doncic. A rebound by Washington.
Well, he has to work harder to get a good high percentage look. I mean, he's been taking some bad shots out there.
Outside, Ball. Rozier. That falls. Nice feed that time from Ball. Ball's got 3 assists tonight.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Both teams will make substitutions. Chance now to take a look at some of the steal numbers over the scope of the last few months for him.
I feel like he hasn't been paying as much attention to the defensive aspect of the game as he needs to. His steals have dropped over the past few months, and he needs to get back some of that fire on D.
Here's Bertans. He's averaging around 5.5 points a game. Dinwiddie with the bucket.
And a nice job here early of establishing an inside presence.
We've got 1:13 left to play in the first. Dinwiddie against Ball. To the middle. He's looking for Harrell and finds him. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
And coming up, Montrezl Harrell said he patterned his game after the All-Star Zach Randolph. Z-Bo was undersized on paper but was strong as an ox and found angles to finish.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls. And like the great Z-Bo, Montrezl Harrell might be undersized on paper, but Greg, that 7'4 wingspan levels the playing court.
Not to mention his leaping ability. Harrell's more of a dunker, quite honestly, but he also displays that soft touch inside.
And both free throws good for Harrell.
And you think about 2020 as a real breakout year for Montrezl Harrell. Named sixth man of the year in the NBA. He was averaging 18 points a game.
Now here's Dinwiddie. He picked up 18 points in their last win against Boston.
I mean, if you look at his free throw numbers, I mean, it shows you how much pressure he put on the defense.
Shot clock at 5. Dallas needs to get off a shot. Bertans can't get it to go.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Ball with the bucket.
This is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
There's 31 seconds left in the first quarter. Here's Brunson. In the corner, it's Dinwiddie. And the call will be against LaMelo Ball. That'll be his second foul of the game.
I mean, that's a tough break for the D. I mean, he took the hit and drew the whistle.
Defense doesn't get much better than the mobile one block we just saw on replay.
And big defensive plays like that will help them stay in control of this one.
Here's Brunson. 1 second separating the shot clock and game clock. Up and in on the layup. Brunson's got his second bucket of the night.
Now how about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
And so it's the Charlotte Hornets holding on to an 8-point lead heading into the break. Their shooting has been the big key. Their percentage from the field so far has been terrific. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. And for those of you just tuning in, the second quarter of action is where we're at right now. And a look now at how the offensive approach has been going here so far for the Hornets.
Well, they're just a team in sync right now. Their passion in the first half has been outstanding.
And also, it's been a positive to watch that they've attacked the paint offensively as well. It's really been about the balance that they've shown.
Hornets leading by 8. Plumlee out there with McDaniels. Then there's Oubre. Then there's Terry Rozier. And it's Martin in at the small forward. So that's the group out there for Charlotte. Now, here's Rozier. Down through the hoop it goes. That's his 5th make on 9 shots from the floor. Chris, congrats again on your call to the Hall of Fame. Not to put pressure on someone currently in the NBA, but does anyone out there now remind you of you back in the day?
Well, you know what, Kevin, I try not to look at it like that, but there are a lot of players that play the same position, in which I love how they play. I love how Embiid plays. I see similarities. My man Jokic, I definitely see some similarities in the past and tried to make sure that we were point forwards. But I tell you what, instead of seeing similarities in anyone, I tell you what, I'm a fan of all the big fellas because they flat out got game.
And thinking about the energy that Oubre plays with, always, Chris, very active on the floor.
Yeah, and that's something that is always out there for Oubre. Even if the shot is
take
off,
a break.
There's
take a
still
break.
A spark plug for this team. Something that endears you to your teammates.
That free throw, no good.
You know, we've seen flashes of how great Oubre can be. I mean, the key for him is consistency.
Charlotte making some changes. PJ Washington, he's checked in for McDaniels. And it's Bridges in for Martin. Dorian Finney-Smith's checked in for the Mavericks. Luka Doncic comes in for Jalen Brunson. And the second free throw, good. Mavericks trail by 11. Dinwiddie with it. And he can be counted on to put some points on the board every night. He's averaging right around 13.5 points a game. And good that time. Doncic has got 6.
And the mid-range, no longer a challenge for Doncic. He has rapidly become one of the best three-level scorers in the game.
Now, here's Bridges. He picked up 27 points in their last win against Oklahoma City.
Yeah, but it wasn't all about himself. I mean, he kept everybody else in the loop. His passing was tremendous.
Here's Dinwiddie after Terry Rozier's basket. Now, Doncic, 6 points for him. 6 on the shot clock. The rebound by Washington. Washington's got 4 rebounds in this game. On the wing, Bridges. He's covered by Brown. Bridges a screen on Doncic. Here's Rozier, and there's another one for the Hornets.
Check out how attentive Rozier is to positioning, making sure he's at a perfect range to sink it.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Dinwiddie's shot is off. Hornets leading by 13. Oubre on the wing, guarded by Doncic. Oubre kicks to Rozier. Plumlee sets the pick for Rozier. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
Well, you need a decision maker to be running the pick and roll, and Rozier is the man for that. He frees the defense very well.
Here in the second quarter, we've played a little over 2.5 minutes now, and we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Good evening, Kevin. Now, the NBA does get high marks for its diversity, but there is some frustration on that front when you look at head coaches and front office positions. All-star Karl Anthony Towns said, "Men of color deserve a chance to lead a team, run an organization, and make their mark, not just with a jersey on, but with a suit on." Guys?
Thank you, David. Now, here's Bridges after Luka Doncic's miss. Bridges' shot, good. Bridges has got his 3rd basket of the night right there.
Well-rounded effort, and they show no signs of letting up.
Yeah, and it hasn't just been the offensive output. They're putting in the work at the defensive end as well.
Now, here's Brown. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. And out of bounds as the Hornets gain possession. Let's look at the 2K leaderboard to find out the teams that have led the league in steals the season's second half. In 3rd, the Hornets.
You know, the defense has been frenetic, and it seems like they're gaining momentum as the season wears on. I mean, they're forcing a lot of turnovers.
Passes to Washington. That's good, and it's Rozier with the assist. Rozier's got 3 assists now in this one. Charlotte making a switch here. Ball's checked in. Then for the Mavericks, Dwight Powell's checked in for Maxi Kleba. And it's Reggie Bullock in for Brown. Here's Doncic. 6 points for him. Dinwiddie outside. Good. And the assist goes to Doncic. Dinwiddie's got 5 points so far.
Oh, he just caught the defense napping. He shoots a very high percentage from three-point range when there's no hand in his face.
And here's Charlotte. They're on a 14-5 run here.
And Kevin, everybody's dissected Luka's offensive game, trying to find that weakness, and I'm just here to tell you, I don't think he has it. It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
And here is Ball. 5 points in the game. Driving inside. Softly drops in the floater. He has 7. And the play of Doncic drawing comparisons to so many all-time greats. But, Greg, the one that stood out to me, they said he's a combination of Larry Bird and Magic Johnson. What do you think?
And it just makes sense. With his passing and shooting, you throw in the step-back game of James Harden, you start to see why he has become such a problem for this league.
Oubre can't get it to go. So for Dallas, their last game, a win against the Celtics in Boston. Dinwiddie right side. He kicks to Bullock. Shot clock at 6. Driving in. Off target at the rim. Hornets leading by 19 points. Inside, Ball. It's good. Ball's got 4 points now in the quarter.
What a finish by Ball. Great length for a guard, 6'7". He can mix it up.
Dinwiddie against Ball. Powell with a screen on Ball. Here's Dinwiddie. Again, the miss by the Mavericks.
And he has definitely been struggling in this quarter.
Well, just off his game, forcing a few shots, not letting the game come to him naturally.
And Ball slams it in.
Well, check out the hops of Ball. I mean, exploding off the floor for the big slam.
Dallas has gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. Doncic passes to Dinwiddie. Looking to get it going. And the rebound goes to the Hornets. Washington's got 7 rebounds in the game.
+8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Now, here's Ball. They lead by the biggest margin of the game, 23 points.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Dinwiddie against Ball. And the pass to Doncic. That one falls, coming off Dinwiddie's feet. Doncic has got his 3rd basket of the night.
The real. Come at us, and we're coming right back at you.
Yeah, man. Let's talk about it. The great competition going on. That's what makes a matchup like this so much fun to watch.
And some changes here for the Hornets. Harrell, he's checked in for Plumlee. McDaniels comes in for P.J. Washington. And Martin subbed in for Bridges. Then for the Mavericks, Davis Bertans checks in for Dorian Finney-Smith. And it's Jalen Brunson in for Dinwiddie. On defense, Dallas. Here's Ball. It's good. Now he's shooting 6 for 7.
They are just killing him on the interior.
There's a minute left to play here in the half. Pass to Doncic. No good on that one. And Charlotte will go the other way with it.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
Harrell, a screen on Doncic. Ball with the bucket. Ball's got 15 points.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
Dallas has gone 2 of 3 when they've stepped beyond the arc in the second quarter. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Doncic outside. Over Martin. Doncic, no good.
Just not much success when it comes to shooting.
And he lays in the alley-oop.
Oh my goodness. Save that one. I want to see that again.
Me too. Just absolutely beautiful. Here's Brunson. Good. And the assist goes to Doncic. Doncic has got 4 assists now tonight. A big-time effort for Terry Rozier, providing a lot of energy for Charlotte. He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific basketball instinct on display. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much with Hornets head coach James Borrego. Coach, what are you getting from LaMelo Ball in the first half?
Great job, you know, getting us into our sets. Defensively, he's been great. Offensively, getting us into a rhythm, pushing the pace. When we don't have something, getting us into our offense.
He's done it all so far, Coach. Thanks for your time. Back to you.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
Welcome. First up, let's look at the two guys who are each leading their respective teams through the first half.
It's like a supernova colliding. I mean, fans love these star matchups. Always the potential for a huge play. They draw so much attention, it frees up the rest of the team. Oh, and the momentum can change in a heartbeat with these guys on the floor.
And now let's take a look at the excellent first half we've seen so far for the Hornets.
They were in such a groove that entire first half, especially on the offensive end. Good play calling, good execution, and by and large, they take great shots.
And that is it for halftime, folks. It is back to Kevin Harlan and the crew for the second half.
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. Nice game. Great performance by Terry Rozier.
And the way that he has helped out with the ball movement has been a difference maker early on.
And that's somewhat of a surprise, I mean, but he's been really patient and unselfish.
And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. On the floor right now for the Mavericks, Jalen Brunson out there with Doncic. Then there's Dwight Powell. Then there's Reggie Bullock. And it's Finney-Smith in at the 4 spot. Now here's Ball. He's got 15. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Rozier for 3. It's rebounded by Doncic. And so Doncic will bring it up for the Dallas Mavericks. So it's off to Brooklyn after this game as they have the Nets to look forward to. They're in the midst of this long 6-game road trip. That will be game 4. And every year, Terry Rozier seems to get better. Specifically, Greg, becoming a more efficient and lethal scorer.
I mean, he's improving his percentages over the years, especially his three-point shooting. When he came into the league, was not a threat from deep. Now, you have got to honor that outside shot.
Rozier for three. Powell pulls it in. Powell's got four rebounds in this game. Bullock with it. He's against Bridges. Brunson finds Doncic. Six to shoot. A floater. He lays it in. Doncic has got the first points of the third quarter up on the board for Dallas.
And already in his career, Doncic displays a remarkable amount of pro moves, including that floater right there.
Now, here's Rozier. He's got 17. Outside ball.
I see him.
It's rebounded by Doncic. Doncic has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Brunson, no good. Charlotte's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Plumlee sets the pick for Bridges. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Bridges has got 8 points.
Yeah, three consecutive field goals have come right at the rim. The D had better start buckling now.
Pass to Brunson. Powell in the high post, working on Plumlee. Powell inside. He's guarded by Plumlee. That shot, no good.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
Pass to Washington. And then Washington with the dunk.
Serious verticality from Washington. Soars up to the rim and throws it down.
And so it's Dallas with it. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Here's Doncic, and the dunk by Doncic.
The finish was nice, but the setup was better.
Yeah, GA, the pick working to full effect before the stuff.
Yeah, coach is definitely pleased. That's the execution he loves to see.
And it's the Hornets with the ball, following the score by Dallas. Here's Ball, and Ball slams it in.
Big offensive performance from Ball so far, showing the league what he's capable of.
3 minutes gone now in the third quarter. Dallas calls timeout, and the NBA introducing new measures to discourage fan misconduct. Greater security and pursuing legal action, Chris, when that line is crossed.
Yeah, Kevin, we're living in interesting times, my friend. People may need to blow off steam, but I'll tell you this, the players are here to entertain, but not as punching bags.
A different look for Dallas. Maxi Kleba, he's checked in for Dwight Powell. Sterling Brown comes in for Reggie Bullock. And Dinwiddie's subbed in for Luka Doncic. Up top, Brown. Defended by Bridges. Back to Brown. The pass to Brunson. Five on the clock. Dallas, no good that time either.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
Here's Plumlee, and they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
And that's 10 straight points in the paint. The defense, nowhere to be found.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
Not the best statistic for him in terms of his performance at the line. Very low numbers.
Shooting one.
And that one misses. You know, Greg, sometimes it's just hard to quantify defense, but some new age metrics really value Mason Plumlee.
And there's a stat called defensive box plus minus that measures how good your team is with you on the floor. Year in, year out, Mason Plumlee is top 20 in the league, proving his overall effect on a game on the defensive end.
And it's ball penetrating, and he can't jam it through. And so it's Dinwiddie who brings up the ball for the Dallas Mavericks. Kleba with a screen on Plumlee. The kick out to Brown, and that's out of bounds. Dallas will retain possession. And a look now at the Hornets' upcoming schedule. On Wednesday, they'll be taking on Clint Capella and the Atlanta Hawks. Then on Saturday, it'll be the Dallas Mavericks coming into town.
And you know, for that Knicks game, that's a contest that could easily go either way. Small mistakes could be the difference, and both teams will need to be at their best.
Here's Dinwiddie.
Now, you have to respect the hustle when Rozier is active on defense like this. It makes a difference.
Back to ball. Bridges sets the screen for ball. Rozier kicks to Plumlee. Washington passes to Rozier. Over Kleba. On the wing, Bridges. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Bridges has got 5 points now in the quarter.
His individual effort has been outstanding tonight, and it's helped him grab the lead.
Pass to Brunson. From the arc. The Hornets pull it in.
He's done almost no damage from three-point range in this game. No threes in this half, and only one in the first.
Ball finds Bridges. The kick out to Rozier. Offline with his three.
And, you know, he's a threat from deep, no doubt about it, but it just has not been there for him tonight. You might want to change your game plan a little bit offensively.
And now let's highlight the highest scoring teams in the NBA. In second, the Hornets.
And how about the year they've had offensively? This is a team that can put points on the board in a hurry. Always fun to watch them play.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw good from Brown. So an almost entirely new group in now for Charlotte. Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for Plumlee. McDaniels comes in for Washington. Martin's checked in for Bridges. And Oubre subbed in for Ball. And Dallas also making a switch. Berton has checked in. That one misses, so he goes one for two.
Just a kinetic force inside. Kevin, you know Montrezl Harrell is high flying, high scoring. And he does it with high efficiency.
Here's Brunson. Great D that time from Harrell.
Playing him tough inside and preventing the layup. Gotta get the whole team pumped up.
Martin kicks to Rozier. Harrell against Brunson. Harrell the pass to Martin. Second chance shot. And Harrell with the lay-in. Good.
If you don't put a body on Harrell, I mean, what can you expect? He's coming with intent.
Dallas has gotten blank from three-point land so far in the third. Still 0 for 3. And Harrell, one of the better scorers in the league on a per-minute basis.
Yeah, Kevin, he gets it done inside. He may not be a playmaker, but he is a play terminator.
Oubre can't get it to go. The Mavericks shooting a pretty sorry 29% from the floor here. Bertans finds Brunson. 1:25 left in the third. Bertans, a screen on Oubre. Brunson, and he uses both hands to jam it in.
Who knows what this score would look like if he wasn't on his game tonight.
Charlotte's gone 5 of 10 from downtown tonight, 50% exactly. Now, here's McDaniels. Bertans defending. No one near Rozier as he lets it fly. And a miss there on the triple. Dallas shooting 31% here in the third. Offensively, they are looking bleak. Dinwiddie dishes to Brown. Oubre against Dinwiddie. Here's Brunson. Sinks the triple. Brunson's got 7 points here in this quarter.
Wow, his first triple of the second half gives him 2 on the night. He's not making much of an impact from deep.
Harrell kicks to Oubre. It's Martin on the wing. Out of bounds, it'll be Mavericks ball. And some changes here for the Mavericks. Dwight Powell's checked in for Maxi Kleba. Reggie Bullock comes in for Brown. And Doncic is subbed in for Jalen Brunson. Dallas has gone into a slump here from three-point range, shooting just 1 of 5 here in the third. Doncic against Harrell. Now, here's Doncic. Clock at 6. Let's it go from deep. Unable to get that one. And so it's Charlotte, rolling along with a 27-point lead as we wrap up a quarter. They've been playing some ferocious defense. We've got more in store for you right after this. And now a sneak peek into the huddle with Coach Jason Kidd.
We're not talking to each other. Offensively or defensively, let's talk.
And Coach Jason Kidd citing one of the things that can happen over the course of an evening, a breakdown in communication.
And the problem is, even in a league of superstars, this is ultimately a team game. You have to work together to succeed.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. McDaniels is out there with Harrell. Then it's Thomas. And it's Martin in at the 2. So that's the Hornets 5. Thomas, no good. And it's Burke with the ball for the Dallas Mavericks. Green, the pass to Ntilikina. Bertans a screen. Ntilikina can't hit. Charlotte has gone to the three-pointer 11 times tonight, nailed 5 of them. Harrell, the pass to Thomas. Back to Harrell. Out to the right wing. There's the screen. Here's McDaniels. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim. Dallas shooting terribly up to this point, just 30%. Some ramshackle offense play there. Burke looking over the floor. Pass to Bertans. There's the triple. Hits it from three-point range.
No hesitation. This is a shot Bertans practices all the time.
Outside Thomas. Passes it to Harrell. And the rebound goes to the Mavericks. Bertans got 4 rebounds now tonight. Here's Ntilikina. He's guarded by Thomas. The pass to Burke. Greg, player movement is always a constant in the NBA, but with more players on the move every year, the power balance can shift in the blink of an eye.
And we've seen it with the Lakers, right? Just a few years ago. The Nets and a few others. Not everyone, though, loves it, but it sure keeps things interesting.
And that one's good, Richard.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Yeah, they're pouring it on right here, trying to give the opposition no light at the end of the tunnel.
Here's Burke after the basket by Charlotte, and Jalen McDaniels picks up the foul. That's his first foul. And a new group getting ready for Dallas. Maxi Kleba, he's checked in for Dwight Powell. Dorian Finney-Smith comes in for Green. Jalen Brunson, he's checked in for Neal Akina. And Luka Doncic subbed in for Trey Burke. Fourth quarter of play, and we're about 2.5 minutes through it right now. No one near Doncic as he lets it fly. Drills the three-pointer.
And when he's knocking down the triple, pack it up. There's nothing you can take away from Luka.
Hornets leading by 23. Martin finds ball. Shoots over Doncic. Misses off the left iron. Dallas has gotten the three-point bug tonight. They've taken 15 shots outside the arc. They're 6 of 15. And Brunson has it in the corner. Five to shoot. Pass to Kleba. Here's Finney-Smith. That three off the mark.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
Outside for Martin. Bridges outside. Pass the ball. The Hornets need to get a shot off here. Bridges misses. For Dallas, they've gone just 33% from the field in the fourth quarter so far. They are 2 of 6. Pass to Doncic. Kleba with a screen on ball. Doncic against Bridges. Tries it from the top of the key. And the rebound goes to the Hornets. Ball's got his fourth rebound in this one. The game now requires so much movement. Big men have to cover a lot more ground. We know that. They are on the perimeter, Chris. Does that add some strain physically?
Yeah, I mean, maybe. Who knows? But it's less bumps and bruises, which to me was more wear and tear. So I think every case is different. I don't think you could put a blanket statement over that, but you have to have some skill set today. Get out and run and guard in some different positions.
And so it's Dallas with it, following the three by Charlotte. And the call will be against LaMelo Ball. That will get him his fourth foul of the game.
Fourth foul of the game for him. He's starting to get into that danger zone.
McDaniels, he's checked in for Washington. Sterling Brown, he's checked in for the Mavericks. Brunson scanning the floor. Bertans, a screen on ball. The three, nailed from three-point land.
Don't let a 6'10" size fool you. Bertans has finished in the top 10 in three-point shooting a few times.
Ball against Doncic. Ball kicks to Martin. Six on the shot clock. It's hauled in by Brown. Dallas has gone outside a lot tonight. 17 times, in fact. 7 of 17. And there's the drive. Kleba finds Doncic. Solid shot from the distance of about 14 feet. 18 points for Luka Doncic.
And so often acting as the catalyst, Doncic there playing off the ball, ready to catch and fire.
Now here is Martin. Left side, ball. There's the pass to Bridges. And it's off from three-point range. Mavericks trail by 21. Brown feeling it out a bit. We've got 1:48 left to play in the final quarter. Bertans, a screen on Bridges. And it's Brown missing. And so it's Ball with it. He brings it up for the Hornets. We're so fortunate to have so many versatile bigs in today's NBA, Chris. But of those bigs, who do you enjoy watching the most?
Oh, I love watching Jokic and Embiid. I mean, have you seen what those guys can do? Post up, step out, hit threes, control that corner action. They're able to carry their team.
Now, here's Doncic. Following the miss by LaMelo Ball. Brunson with a clean look. Good. And the assist goes to Doncic. Brunson's got 10 points in just the second half. Here's Ball.
And tonight's battle is going to end with a very clear winner, leaving nothing to chance. Impressive win for the Hornets.
In the end, they had a better shooting percentage, and that's what made the difference. Sometimes, you know, things go your way. The other team wasn't catching many lucky breaks themselves.
Yeah, and Kevin, not all about luck. I thought their overall shot selection was better.
And so now, on the year, they'll have 35 wins to their credit.
And they're able to even the score of this series at a game apiece. Still, two more to go in the season series.
And as usual, some excellent work tonight in what was a quality big impact game for LaMelo Ball.
What a teammate he was tonight, setting guys up for layups and open jumpers on what seemed like every possession.
Now, here's Bertans. Following the miss by Montrezl Harrell, Doncic finds Kleba. Pass to Bertans. Another three for Dallas.
Look, it's always great to get into a rhythm, but do it when it matters.
Yeah, it has to be frustrating to catch fire when the game is already over. I mean, this is not the outcome they wanted.
Now, here's Bridges. 19 seconds left in the fourth quarter. It's stolen by Bertans. Here's Bullock. So no problem for Charlotte as they get the win. Some good moments throughout this one, but they had the clear advantage down the stretch.
Yeah, I mean, I love the way they executed on both ends of the floor, completely under control for the vast majority of the game. And whenever there was a misstep, they just didn't allow it to fester, and that's why they're going to walk away with the win.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, guys. Miles, congrats on the win. Can this team carry the momentum into the next game?
Well, I think we're just going to approach the game like we have been these last games. We've been playing very hard, moving the ball, and playing great defense. So if we approach it like that, I think we'll win.
Thanks again for your time, man. Back to you.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. And that about wraps it up. For Chris Weber, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thank you for being with us. And now, we present the New Balance Player of the Game, LaMelo Ball.